sacrificing everything for the performance of a lifetime. It's what drove a skater like Kristi Yamaguchi to dedicate her life to the pursuit of the ultimate goal, Olympic gold. And it's that same spirit and dedication that Kristi celebrates today. With the Salt Lake Games barely a month away, Kristi has gathered an impressive group of national, world, and Olympic champions. Friends who have shared Kristi's dream and drive, and skaters who honor their Olympic past while celebrating the spirit and traditions that fuel the dreams of future generations of Olympic hopefuls. NBC Sports proudly presents Hallmark Salute to Gold, starring Kristi Yamaguchi. Good afternoon and welcome everyone to the Arrowhead Pond in Anaheim, California, for a very special day of skating.
Hello everyone, I'm Tom Hammond, along with 1984 Olympic silver medalist Roslyn Sumners. And Ros, we have quite a lineup to look forward to today.
We sure do. And Tom, with the Olympics barely a month away, the excitement is building. And the Olympic spirit is certainly in the air, especially today, where Kristi has brought together a group of her closest friends who also happen to be some of the most decorated Olympic and national champions in the sport. Now also lending his legendary talents today as choreographer, Christopher Dean, who also won gold in 1984 with dance partner Jane Torres. And he is a perfectionist who commands the respect of everyone he has ever worked with.
Well, among the skaters we'll be seeing today, 1988 Olympic gold medalist Brian Boitano, as well as Kristi's friend and former rival Midori Ito, who earned silver to Kristi's gold in 1992. And she'll be performing in a setting such as this for the first time ever. It's an exciting couple of hours of skating, and it's just moments away.
And our skaters are backstage getting ready for their opening number, a number in which the talents of choreographer Christopher Dean are immediately and appropriately on display.
Being that this is a salute to gold and an Olympic tribute, I thought he would be perfect for the choreography, and just an honor to have him be a part of the show and to share his talent with all the other skaters. So hopefully, even though the audience won't see him, hopefully they'll see his signature out on the ice.
He's a great choreographer and a good, you know, great director, but he's really good at knowing when to pull back and say, hey, okay, just keep it in mind, this is what I want you to do, and go for it when it comes time to really perform it.
Working with all of the aspects of skating, whether it's singles or pairs or dance, becomes its own excitement, really, because having not necessarily having the background, you want to experiment a little bit more, and maybe you try things that they haven't done before, like a pair skater, because from competition they tend to do what they do, and then when we go into a choreographic session, we challenge them a little bit more with the body movements and steps that they do.
It makes for a better show. You know, he has a good understanding, creative mind, and so he does ask us to, you know, think of something as opposed to just, you know, doing something you already do. Can you make up something different? Is it possible? So, but that's his mind, you know, he works like that, and it certainly showed in his skating, and it'll show in all his choreography.
We were children stepping hesitantly onto the ice for the first time, in lands far apart, yet with the same sense of wonder. Distance by oceans, we were united by unusual qualities, the will to work hard and the joy of skating with an intense passion.
Kristi setting the tone of this show, the common love and passion for being on the ice. And we're going to be hearing from the skaters throughout the show, their thoughts and reflections, how they made their dreams come true. And it all started with the basic figure eights. With Kristi, these skaters have shared their lives on and off the ice, and we'll see that camaraderie on display throughout the day.
And there's our host, 92 Olympic gold medalist Kristi Yamaguchi.
Jenny Mino and Todd Sands, two-time national pairs champions, along with two-time Olympic pairs bronze medalists Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisner.
National champion Stephen Cousins.
And world champion Brian Boitano.
Silver medalist Midori Ito. And when we come back, the USA's resurgent Todd Eldridge performs.
I wanted to give you these. One's for if you win, and one's for, well, if you don't.
Excuse me, Ben.
I'm gonna go now. Good luck, sweetheart.
You go to 6 a.m. practices, endure endless drives, tough workouts, and you're not even an athlete. You're a mom who knows how nourishing Campbell's chicken noodle soup is. It warms kids up and helps keep them going. all the way to their dreams. Warm up with Campbell's, official soup supplier of the 2002 Olympic Winter Games.
Welcome back to Hallmark Salute to Gold, starring Kristi Yamaguchi from Anaheim, where American Todd Eldridge continues to pursue his passion for figure skating over a professional and Olympic career that has had more than its share of peaks and valleys.
In 1998, didn't have any injuries, physical anyway. I skated well in the short program. I was in third place and, you know, poised to hopefully take home a medal and have a shot at winning the thing. And, things just didn't feel great in the long program, and, you know, a little bit of nerves kicked in and faltered on a couple things, you know, one too many, which dropped me right out of the medals.
That Olympic disappointment has only fueled his competitive desire as the 30-year-old seized a world bronze medal last March.
I've been at this a lot longer than most of the guys I'm competing against, and for me to be a bronze medalist 10 years after I was a bronze medalist at the World Championships back in 91, you know, it says a lot, and it's great to know that, you know, I can still do it and still go out there and do great performances. And, you know, I think that this year coming up that's the one thing I want to do. You know, medals are great, but the one thing that I haven't done and that I really want to do at the Olympic Games is have two great performances.
Motivated for one more run at an elusive Olympic medal, Eldridge welcomes the challenge to perform for a highly partisan crowd.
You know, it's something that I'm definitely looking forward to, and I can't wait to see how great it is to compete for the United States in the United States.
And Todd has spent the past 4 years focusing and pacing himself for the one thing he wants more than anything, that Olympic medal. And he is skating to the music 1492, a perfect showcase for his speed and power. Well, he's made the commitment in his heart. He's prepared. He's hungry. Now all it takes is putting it together when it counts.
And our host getting pumped up when Hallmark Salute to Gold starring Kristi Yamaguchi continues. Back at the pond in Anaheim, California, and Hallmark Salute to Gold, where one of the many strengths of the star of our show has always been her ability to balance competitive success with the ties that bind a loving family, as we look back at Kristi's Olympic experience in this Hallmark memory.
We were really looking more to just experience the whole thing with her. You know, whether she came home with a medal or not, that would have been a bonus. But being able to go and see her in the opening ceremonies along with all the other athletes, and just being able to see at least that part of her dream come true. And it was really more all about that. The fact that she happened to come home with a gold medal just made it all the more special.
The only thing more special to the Yamaguchis than the experience are the memories.
You remember almost every moment of training and every downside you've had in your career. And you think back and think, wow, it's been worth it. This is more than I ever dreamed of. And I remember stepping out as they announced me to take the place on the podium. The first thing I did was try to look for my family in the audience because I knew they were there and I wanted to share that moment with them.
It was a really proud moment for her, but I think it was a great moment for the family when she, you know, the first thing she did was kind of, she knew exactly where we were sitting and she just looked over there and just was, yeah, you know, I did it. We did it.
Kristi continues to evolve as a performer and a person.
So it's been a really interesting experience, you know, watching her grow into, you know, a role model for kids and really develop into just an admirable woman. And, you know, it's kind of a proud moment, too, you know, as a sister.
There's a feeling of freedom and strength when I skate, an energy coming from within that I want to share with the audience. There are times when I never want the performance to end.
And the growth and versatility in Kristi's skating evident here in an edgy number, the music by Janet Jackson and choreographed by one of Janet's choreographers, Tina Landley.
She's fine.
She's accomplished so much since standing on the top of the podium, and the generation of skaters coming up admire and respect her career. Kristi has shown that the Olympic gold medal is really just the beginning.
While still at the top of her game, Kristi Yamaguchi, now 30 years old. And we'll be back to the Hallmark Salute to Gold in just a moment.
Want to try that triple Lux?
What the heck? I got supplemental insurance.
What's that?
Aflac! A Lux?
No, that something something insurance.
Aflac! Even the best insurance doesn't give you cash for things like lost pay and other expenses. This does.
What does?
Aflac!
Aflac. Ask about it at work.
I prefer the Glade scented oil as opposed to the Wizard. The Glade definitely lasts longer.
Glade plug-ins are the only scented oils whose entire line lasts 60 days.
The smell is wonderful.
Plug it in.
Glade plug-ins, the long-lasting scented oil.
It smells great.
You go to 6 a.m. practices, endure endless drives, tough workouts, and you're not even an athlete. You're a mom who knows how nourishing Campbell's chicken noodle soup is. It warms kids up and helps keep them going all the way to their dreams. Warm up with Campbell's, official soup supplier of the 2002 Olympic Winter Games.
The more you live, the more you love, the more you laugh, the more a bladder control issue shouldn't hold you back. Discover new Serenity Slender. A breakthrough creates three layers of protection. The core of Super Absorbers keeps you drier in our thinnest design ever. Even the leading maxi doesn't come close to letting you feel this free. New Serenity Slender. More protection, less pad. Now that's more you.
Why do Hershey's Kisses love to perform? Because the crowd just eats them up. Little Hershey's Kisses, big chocolate taste.
They love to skate. They love the music. They love the feeling of the ice. They love being world champions. But there is one thing that Canadian figure skaters Saleh and Peltier would love most of all, an Olympic gold. Will their love win in 2002? The Olympics return to America this February on NBC.
Welcome back to Hallmark Salute to Gold, starring Kristi Yamaguchi. Tom Hammond with Rosalind Sumners. And Roz, our next pair of skaters have a special reason to remember the Olympics fondly.
Well, Tom, Jenny Minow and Todd Sands' crowd-pleasing connection on the ice is no coincidence. It's a relationship that's even more successful off the ice, as we find out in this Hallmark memory.
In 1994, I think it's a very special Olympics for us. Olympics is always so special, representing your country and competing with the other athletes, and also the fact that we were engaged there about an hour before the short program.
It was kind of a spur of the moment. I'd been thinking about it for a while, and then
just popped out,
yeah.
And actually, we kind of kept it to ourselves because, you know, we were competing in the Olympics.
Though the pair would skate together again in the 98 games, their experience in Lillehammer will always be foremost.
It was to skate the best you can at the Olympic Games is probably one of the biggest thrills in sports, I think. And that was definitely a high point for us in 1994.
And I think the amazing thing about the Olympics, there's always so many American fans there, and they have the flags and the, you know, the sweaters and the hats, and it just, I don't know, it's really an incredible feeling and something that you really can't describe, seeing all those people up there when you're out on the ice and when you finish your performance.
When I take the ice and Todd is beside me, he gives me strength and confidence.
Our love for skating and each other takes over, and we become one.
You can feel the love and support they have for each other as they skate. And what a thrill to be able to have that hand to hold on to out there on the ice.
Turn down the lights, turn down the bed.
tell me no lies, just hold me close, don't patronize, don't
Olympic feelings and memories have carried them into a very successful professional career, always a favorite with the audience.
Husband and wife, Jenny Mino and Todd Sayer. Olympic and world champion Brian Boitano skates next when Hallmark's Salute to Gold starring Kristi Yamaguchi continues. Welcome back to Hallmark's Salute to Gold, starring Kristi Yamaguchi at the pond in Anaheim, where 1988 gold medalist Brian Boitano's recollection of his Olympic moment is as clear today as it was 14 years ago.
The most memorable moment, obviously, and forever in my life will be the moment that I won the Olympics. The feeling of, it's still the 4.5 minutes that I to this day, 13 years after, can go back and tell you exactly what I was thinking at every moment. You could stop a still picture of the videotape in the middle of the program and say, what were you thinking here? And I know what I was thinking. I was so in the moment. I was so in the zone, as you call it. And it was just the most amazing feeling to be in the zone, to have the performance of your life, and to win what was icing on the cake.
Boitano's legendary ability to perform under pressure compares favorably with that of his close friend, Kristi Yamaguchi. And though their gold medals came 4 years apart, little separates their admiration for one another.
She's a stud.
I'm here because anytime I have a chance to work with Kristi Yamaguchi, I will jump at it.
I call her the stud girl.
I can't think of anyone who would be a better role model than Kristi Yamaguchi in every way. I mean, I think that she's a great skater, she's a great person. Her Olympic performance still brought women's figure skating to a new technical level that has not been surpassed and won't be surpassed even by this next Olympic championships coming up. So I think that she's contributed so much to figure skating. Her consistency, her style, and just most of all with the person that she is. She's a great person.
Well, Brian himself is a role model in men's skating. The respect he has for his craft, training, competing, and performing as he continues to set the bar technically, never expecting less from himself than he did at the 88 Olympics.
Thank you.
An elegant piece of music that showcases Brian's passion and emotion on the ice. And as the years move on, he continues to train harder and expect even more.
Olympic champion Brian Boitano. Welcome back to Hallmark Salute to Gold, starring Kristi Yamaguchi, where Olympic memories reverberate, especially for Kristi's good friend, Stephen Cousins, who recognizes that Olympic rewards are not reserved strictly for medal winners.
I always knew I wouldn't be an Olympic champion. I always knew I wouldn't be a world champion. I mean, if the moon, the stars, and the wind, everything lined up perfectly, I could have got a medal somewhere. But in Lillehammer, at the Olympics in the short program, there'd been a bunch of high-name competitors go out first and not skate so well. So when I came out, there was it was kind of like a little bit of a letdown for the crowd. And I skated really well. I was the best I'd ever skated and landed first triple axel in competition by a Brit. So that was really special. And the first person I saw after I landed it and looked into the crowd was Kristi and her sister Lori. So it was that sticks out in my mind. But for me to be able to still perform in at a high level with the likes of Kristi Yamaguchi and Brian Boitano and all these people that are now Olympic champions and also great role models and great people, it's a dream come true.
Out on the ice, it feels like I have no control over what is happening. Like I've been taken to another place and I'm floating there. I'm in the zone. It's hypnotic, it's my life, my love, and my passion.
Stephen just lights up an audience with his energy and personality. He has truly found his home under the spotlight.
Oh, Danny Moore, the fight.
Tenor Robert Feline recorded this Irish classic especially for Stephen, after Stephen saw him perform in a pub near his British home.
The summer's gone and all the leaves are dying. Tis you, must go.
And say, and are there. Steven just draws his audience in, obviously enjoying the fruits of his competitive labors. A skater that is appreciative of every moment on the ice.
And next we'll see Midori Ito skate. Though she won silver to Christie's gold in 92, Ito views their experience as less a rivalry than the seeds of a friendship.
Finally free from the tremendous pressure of competing that Midori always felt, she is now blossoming as a performer. She's thrilled to be skating for fun. Still the technician, but now with grace, beauty, and a newfound joy. A fun, upbeat number from Midori. The American audiences have waited so long to see Kristi and Midori on the ice again together, and I know this has been a thrill for Midori Ito.
And when we come back to the pond in Anaheim, we'll witness the grace and power of Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler as Hallmark Salute to Gold continues. And now it's time for this week's Aflac trivia question. We've seen two of the three ladies medalists from the 1992 Olympics, gold medalist Kristi Yamaguchi and silver medalist Midori Ito, perform here today. But who took home the bronze medal in Albertville? The answer when we come back. Welcome back to Hallmark Salute to Gold, starring Kristi Yamaguchi. And here's the answer to our Aflac trivia question. Who took home the ladies' bronze medal from the 1992 Olympic Games in Albertville?
Well, Tom, none other than America's Nancy Kerrigan shared the podium with Kristi and Midori. And it's been fun to watch these three ladies move on with their lives, and yet the ice is always first.
And Roz, as we watch Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler make their final preparations to skate, the inspiration for a performance can come from all directions. A collaborative effort that Brasseur and Eisler embrace with their choreographer, Julie Marcotte.
We heard the piece of music and thought that we really could do something creative to this. Julie then went on vacation to Cuba, came back with this great idea that she wanted us to skate with fire.
because she had seen it in an act down at a show she had gone to. Well, obviously that wasn't going to happen, but we've created something that is very much the same. It's a good avenue for us because we like to be exciting, we like to be fast and very much entertain the crowd. We're not into doing sort of the Olympic moves that we did for, you know, 20 years. We want to do something new, and we're always trying to bring new moves to the ice that maybe you wouldn't see on the ice.
Always experimenting with new looks, new props, and of course those exciting lifts. She's the mother of a one-year-old daughter. He's engaged to be married. Their lives move on, but they are the happiest when they are on the ice together, creating the magic. The guts and confidence of Isabel Brasseur, the faith she has in Lloyd, doing lifts and moves that no other pair attempts.
And there's much more to come when we return, including Brian Boitano, Kristi Yamaguchi, and three-time world silver medalist and one of this year's Olympic gold medal favorites, Irina Slutskaya, as Hallmark's Salute to Gold continues.
Welcome back to Hallmark's Salute to Gold, starring Kristi Yamaguchi from The Pond in Anaheim, California. Tom Hammond back with Rosalind Sumners. And Roz, a change of mood coming up in these next performances.
Oh, there definitely is, Tom. And we're going to get to see a more playful side of these great competitors and performers, along with the unveiling of some more exciting programs skated in front of an audience for the very first time.
And Roz will see that right now as Irina Slutskaya prepares to skate to the music of Samson and Delilah, a program she had worked on a mere 3 weeks.
You know, I'm not nervous. Of course I feel something here, because this is new and I want to see, I want to listen how people will take this. I mean, like, how crowd will be big or they doesn't understand it. But I think it's easy and they will understand it. When I was 4 years, I'm just crying. But when I grow up, I start to love it. More and more. Now it's my life. It's mean everything to me.
Irina is one of the favorites for gold in Salt Lake City. She's a tough competitor, a technician, and yet today we see a softer side of her skating. Well, competing is her forte, and so close to Salt Lake City, really the moment of her life. It's fun to see her smile and enjoy the freedom of just performing.
Looking forward to Salt Lake City next month, Russia's Irina Slutskaya. The husband and wife team, Mino and Sand, when Hallmark Salute to Gold, starring Kristi Yamaguchi, continues. Welcome back to Hallmark Salute to Gold, starring Kristi Yamaguchi, where earlier we saw Todd Eldridge recreate the performance that won him a world bronze medal last March. Now the Olympic hopeful takes this next opportunity to try something new.
The performance is a new one for me, and it's the song, your song, from Moulin Rouge. And actually, Stephen Cousins is the one that said, you gotta listen to this music, and he played it for me, and I listened to it, and I thought, wow, that's great, you know, I gotta skate to that. So, I've been putting that together for the last few weeks, and I think it's a great song, and hopefully the crowd, will enjoy it.
When I'm skating, I feel like an eagle, the way I can soar across the ice like a bird on a wing. When everything is just right, there's nothing I can't do.
Showcasing Todd's trademark spins, the U.S. Nationals next week, when Todd is looking to nail that Olympic berth and wanting to peak in Salt Lake for the moment he's been waiting for.
Now as an elder statesman, Todd trying to make one more Olympic team. Meanwhile, our resident lovebirds prepare to skate one more time, certainly not the first time that Kristi Yamaguchi played a part in bringing them together.
But one of my first memories of Jenny and Kristi was in an international competition.
Jenny and I were kind of the two shy, you know, like, giggly little girls.
And it was right around Halloween, and they had a Halloween party.
We didn't really have any costumes, so Jenny and I kind of made up our costumes from the bed sheets.
Jenny and Kristi were dressed in togas, and they were afraid to come out of the door. They couldn't decide if what they were wearing was appropriate.
This was a long time ago.
That was one of my very first memories of Kristi and Jenny.
It must have caught Todd's eye as far as Jenny was concerned.
Fun to see what great friends they've become after all the years of touring and competing together. And Tom, everyone thinks they're a quiet couple, and after touring with them, I know them a little differently. And this fun number shows another side of their personalities.
I thought love was so true with fairy tales.
Touring, and he golfs with the guys, she enjoys the girls' nights out. Yet touring can be hard, a hard life, and yet they get to share it together.
And when we return to Anaheim, Midori Ito skates to Romeo and Juliet when Hallmark Salute to Gold starring Kristi Yamaguchi continues in just a moment.
America, we really wanted to participate in the Olympic Winter Games. But in the end, we decided to support the real athletes and stick to the things we do best. Like improving your performance by turning your checking account into an investment tool.
And now, Kristi Yamaguchi.
I've never seen you looking so lovely as you did tonight. I've never seen you shine so bright. Lady,
now you can feel like this and eat pizza. Introducing Smart Ones Pizza, a whole new line of personal pizzas with spicy pepperoni, diced tomatoes, and roasted garlic, loaded with cheese on a delicious gourmet crust.
Lady,
new Smart Ones Pizzas. When you're smart, it shows.
Welcome back to The Pond in Anaheim and Hallmark Salute to Gold, starring Kristi Yamaguchi.
And Tom, I think Midori Ito enjoys this style of skating. Now performing to an operatic interpretation of Romeo and Juliet by Maria Callas.
Thank you.
of joy on her face. Midori Ito, known for her triple axel, which only a few women have performed in competition. She's still a powerful triple jumper and yet now a more polished skater. Very busy life in Japan, performing for the Prince Hotel year-round. And as a commentator for Japanese television, what a thrill to see her here today.
And as we've seen with so many of these great champions, simply being a part of the Olympics is its own reward. And while winning a medal is the ultimate goal, there are many personal achievements that are just as satisfying.
Together, we had three Olympics. 92, yes, we did got the bronze, but we were not satisfied of how we skated. And it's one thing to win a medal, and it's another thing to be satisfied.
At that point in our career, obviously, we knew exactly what we needed to have the best shot at coming out with a great program during the Olympic Games. That was our third Games. We knew what to expect, so there were going to be no surprises. We really wanted to skate as well as we could. So going into Lillehammer, we were quite prepared, quite ready. We went out, we skated two great programs. The feelings we had leaving the Games were one of complete satisfaction.
And I think that we were just lucky to have a chance again to go back, win the same medal. It's the bronze, it's the same bronze, but I look at it and it looks, in my heart, it's a different color, because it could have been silver, it could have been chocolate in 94. I could have cared less, because, you know, we went out there and we skated our best.
When we are really skating well together, it feels like we are just one person.
It's as if I'm floating and as light as a feather.
And as I know, one of the hardest things to accomplish is that perfect performance at the Olympic moment. It's every skater's goal and what you relive forever. And now another wild number jam-packed with tricks, where Lloyd does throw Isabel around as if she were a feather. Champions are never satisfied with less than their best, and Lloyd and Isabel went back to the Olympics and accomplished just that, which does make it all that much sweeter. And now they have had a gem of a professional career.
Lots more skating still to come from Anaheim. Welcome back to Hallmark Salute to Gold, starring Kristi Yamaguchi. And next on the ice, the woman many feel can win the gold in Salt Lake next month.
And Tom, I guarantee you for the next month, all that will be going through this girl's mind are those final moments. Everything you've ever dreamt of, and it means everything. Tell you, she's as physically fit as she can be, and those final moments that I mentioned really become a mental battle, and I know we're all holding our breath to see who stands atop of that podium in Salt Lake City.
We'll be seeing a lot more of her in the coming weeks. Arina Slutskaya of Russia. And we'll have more Brian Boitano when Hallmark Salute to Gold continues from the pond in Anaheim.
I'm standing right now outside the New Skin bus, where a professional team of hairstylists and makeup artists prepare to make up our skaters before they step on the ice. Let's check it out. As the official personal care sponsor of the 2002 Olympic Winter Games, New Skin will be helping figure skaters look their best with a variety of innovative products. Olympic athletes aren't the only ones who can experience behind-the-scenes beauty from Nu Skin. Log on to NuSkinUSA.com and find out how you, too, can experience Nu Skin's beauty of innovation.
Welcome back to Hallmark Salute to Gold, starring Kristi Yamaguchi. And next on the ice, Kristi's good friend, Brian Boitano.
I saw my first ice show at 6 years old. And from that moment on, I knew that skating was my destiny. And I dreamed of one day becoming an Olympic champion.
I remember when Brian didn't make the podium at Nationals in 1982. We went for a walk in the snow after, and he was seriously considering quitting. But he didn't, and Brian then did have the performance of his life in Calgary in 1988. He is proof of what perseverance and believing can do. His continuing perseverance and dedication is an inspiration to all of the skaters. What an amazing career he's had.
The timeless skating of Brian Boitano. And the final performance of the afternoon by our host, Kristi Yamaguchi, as Hallmark Salute to Gold continues in a moment. Welcome back for a very appropriate close to an afternoon dedicated to the Olympic spirit.
To me, it's about striving to reach your goal, no matter what it is in your area of life, whether it's the Olympics or something else, but working hard and putting up the good fight. You question yourself along the way and you question what you're doing and if it's good enough or right. But in the end, you have to know that you gave it your best shot and this is the life you've chosen. Looking back 9 years ago, I never thought I would still be here at 30 and doing as much skating as I am. But I think the passion for it is still there. Just knowing that the audience is still out there, I think, is a motivating factor for me. I still feel that artistically and emotionally, I still have a lot to give. You know, maybe getting a little rusty, but I still enjoy it, and hopefully I can give something to the audience still.
Well, she's hardly getting rusty, but she is a perfectionist, and that's what draws Kristi back to the ice every day. And this song, appropriately titled Gold, sung by a good friend and Broadway star, Linda Eder.
I wonder.
Well, I don't think the hair coming loose was planned, but she seemed to handle it okay.
Well, Tom, she handles everything with class and grace, and now balancing a busy personal life with her husband, professional hockey player Brett Hedekin. And she has made this skating world so much more special because of her presence.
So a wonderful display of talented champions getting to show a different side today and honoring the Olympic spirit.
And Tom, with the opening ceremonies just around the corner, watching these great performers and competitors has me that much more excited to see who the next generation of champions will be.
And who knows, maybe now elder statesman Todd Eldridge can get on that podium finally, and what a great story that would be. We thank you for joining us for a Hallmark Salute to Gold starring Kristi Yamaguchi. I'm Tom Hammond.
And I'm Rosalind Sumner saying so long from Anaheim.
Everything we have experienced, all the years of training, the triumphs and the tears, lead to the arena and the moment of truth. The chance to express ourselves in the best way we know how. The chance to shine, the chance for gold.
Some dreams.